Hello friends, here in this video we will see a problem in which a body is being subjected to two mutually perpendicular directions in which there are stresses, and for that we have to find some values. Here is the question. I'll read the question and write the data along with that. And this question, it belongs to principal stresses and planes. It is given that at a point in a stressed body, the principal stresses are 100 meganewton per meter square tensile. So this is the stress. I'll take it along x direction. So sigma x, it is 100 meganewton per meter square, which is nothing but 100 megapascal. This value is 100 megapascal, which will be 100 newton per mm square. So similarly, the next stress which is given, that is 600 meganewton per meter square, it is compressive. So sigma y will be, since compressive, so negative, minus 600. Now I can directly write down meganewton per meter square as newton per mm square. Next, calculate the normal and shear stress on a plane. So normal stress is sigma suffix n, and shear stress is sigma suffix t. So on a plane which is inclined at 50 degree to the plane, carrying 100 megapascal stress, so theta is 50 degree. Now after we have written the data, let us try to get the solution to this problem. Now in the solution part, first I'll draw the diagram. Here we have a member. It is given that the member is subjected to two kinds of stresses, one along x and the other is along y. So I'll mark the stresses. Along x, it is tensile. Value is 100 newton per mm square. Along y, it is compressive, so negative. So it is 600 newton per mm square. And now it is given that calculate normal and shear stress on a plane inclined at 50 degree, the plane is inclined at 50 degree, to the plane carrying 100 megapascal stress. So if I see in the diagram, this is the plane, vertical plane, which is carrying 100 newton per mm square stress. So to this plane, we have another plane which is inclined, and this inclination of the oblique plane, which I can say, it is 50 degree. So here I'll write down theta is equal to 50 degree. And once we know this theta, because we have to find normal stress and shear stress on this oblique or the inclined plane. So for that, we need to know the inclination of the oblique plane with respect to the vertical. So once we know the angle, we can start with the solution part. So I'll say that since for a body subjected to stresses in two mutually perpendicular directions, normal stress is given by, the formula is, normal stress is equal to sigma x plus sigma y by 2 plus sigma x minus sigma y by 2 into cos 2 theta. So now I'll go on putting the values here to get the normal stress. Sigma x, it is positive because it is tensile. Sigma y, here this will be negative because it is compression. So minus 600 divided by 2 plus sigma x, again positive, sigma y negative, cos 2 theta, theta is 50 degree. So from this, if I calculate sigma n, the normal stress comes out to be, so now if I calculate the values here, my answer of sigma n, it comes out to be minus 310.78 Newton per mm square. So this is the first answer. Next, I'll calculate the tangential stress. Therefore, tangential stress is given by, it is sigma x minus sigma y by 2 into sine 2 theta. So therefore, I will write the value. Sigma x positive because it is along x and tensile. Sigma y, it is compressive, so negative, so minus 600. Theta is 50. So therefore, tangential stress value, it comes out to be 344.68 Newton per mm square. And this is the second answer. And so if we look into the question, they were saying us to calculate the normal and shear stress on a plane which was inclined at 50 degree, that is on the oblique plane. And on that oblique plane, we have found the stress's value, normal stress, as minus 310.78 Newton per mm square, tangential stress 344.68 Newton per mm square. And with this, we complete the problem.